Greetings, Hellcats and Mops. I'm your pilot, Canoeist 420. You are now on board the Dog Speeder Express, your ride to future Los Angeles. This is a high-velocity airbus. All passengers are required to wear a safety restraint. Photography is not permitted. That means you, Jive Turkey. Be respectful. We have a wonderful musical legend on board with us. Without further ado, welcome to the future.
In Snoop Dogg's video, it shows the Buffalo City Hall building. Well, what's the significance with Buffalo, New York, and their City Hall building? Well, I'm going to explain it to you throughout this video. And a couple things that you saw at the end of the video there, you saw a pyramid, Buffalo City Hall. You see that eye, the Eye of Horus. The Eye of Horus, some people call it the Eye of Anubis, which is partly right, but it's not correctly right. It is the Eye of Horus. The Eye of Anubis is the third Eye of Ra, and that'll be explained in this video. But first, I'm going to take you through what the Council of Nine is, where you see it. I'm going to explain that our medical system, our churches, and our system of government is all Lucifer. And you can see it through the imagery, and I'm going to show you where you'll see it in the imagery today. First, we're going to go through a couple ambulances. We have a German ambulance, and you notice that it has on the back of it, it's called the Rod of Asclepius. There's two symbols that you see in the medical industry, and it's the Rod of Asclepius and the Catechus of Hermes. Both of those images represent the same thing with the snakes climbing up a staff, and again, that will be explained. But as I go through these images here of ambulances, you'll see that different ambulances around the world all share the same symbolism. Well, what does that tell you? Well, you look at the pandemic and what has happened, you notice that all the medical systems throughout the world, they're doing the same exact thing. Everyone is masking up. No one's fighting or disputing it. Normally, you can't get two countries to do the same thing on basically anything. If you know, one's a dictatorship and one's a democracy, but yet they're all falling in line. But you see the same symbol that's over all these countries. That symbol that either Rod of Asclepius or Catechus of Hermes symbol is there in every single country, which should tell you that that system is bigger than the country itself. So there is an entity that's outside, because you would think that a government sets up its own medical industry. However, this medical industry is showing you that it's there in every single, no matter if it's a dictatorship, no matter if it's a democracy, no matter if it's a socialist or communist government, they all represent themselves with the Catechus of Hermes and the Rod of Asclepius. Now, I'm going to explain to you what Lucifer is, and if you've seen my other videos, I'm sure that you've seen this before, but Lucifer is the Zodiac, as I'll explain. This is Job 38:32, King James Version. Canst thou bring forth Masareth in his seasons, or canst thou guide Arcturus with his sons? Now, as I explained, that Masareth is another name for the Zodiac, as you see in Job 38:32, is the same scripture, but this one's in the voice. And this is how you decode the Bible. And if you ever want to learn a scripture, just break it down this way and you'll know exactly what it means. So, Job 38:32 in the voice. Can you lead the star of the zodiac out in their proper seasons and guide the bear with her cubs? Now, the bear is another name for Arcturus. And zodiac, again, is another name for Maseroth. Maseroth is another name for the zodiac. And it gets interchanged. Now I'm going to take you to Job 38:32. This is the Wycliffe Bible. And notice how it reads. It's the same scripture again. Whether thou brings forth Lucifer, that is the day star in his time, and make it the even star to rise upon the sons of earth. The even star is the evening star. Okay, so what you're seeing here is Maseroth gets interchanged with Zodiac, and the Zodiac gets interchanged with Lucifer. The star is Arcturus, it's the red giant star, and that is the bear. That's what the Job 38:32 is telling you, and that's how the Bible decodes. So what do we see as the Zodiac? What is the Zodiac? You see in here, the 12 Olympians is laid out as the Zodiac. Okay, the 12 Olympians being Zeus, Hera, Poseidon, Demeter, Athena, Apollo, Artemis, Ares, Hephaestus, Aphrodite, Hermes, and either Hestia or Dionysus. Hestia is a woman, Dionysus is a man. Dionysus is another name for Jesus, and it's all interconnected, those names. Hermes in the evening is Apollo by day. So Apollo and Hermes are the same being. Ares and Hephaestus are the same being. Ares is the beautiful side. He is the god of war, the handsome one. And Hephaestus is the ugly one. And he's the tool maker for war. And then you have Aphrodite. Aphrodite, which is not mentioned on here, is interchanged with Venus. They're two lesbian lovers. If you ever see the lesbian symbol, okay, it goes back to the planet Venus symbol. It's the same thing, and it represents them too. Venus and Aphrodite, the two lesbian lovers. Now, Zeus, if you read in here, is the Council of Nine. This is Greek mythology. When Prometheus gave fire to mankind, Prometheus, again, is another name for Jesus. Okay, Prometheus gave fire to mankind, so, and it infuriated Zeus because Zeus was out there to punish mankind, and he's like, you know, what are you doing? So, what Zeus did is he formed with eight other entities the Council of Nine. Why did he form the Council of Nine? To punish mankind. And I'll read down who the council members are. First, it starts with Zeus, then it's Aphrodite, Apollo, Athena, Demeter, Hephaestus, Hera, Hermes, Poseidon, and Zeus. Now, you see those same names as the 12 Olympians, but I told you that those 12 Olympians break down and they become, ultimately, they become all the way down to one. But they get split up. That's the difference between there being one god and 330 million gods. If you read in the Vedas, basically like Legos, when God the Father destroys a god, he'll take him and make him into another one, take a piece of this god and piece of this god and create a god. And I'm going to go on to more scriptures in the Bible. Now this one here is Matthew 1:17. And I'm just going to read the end of it. Babylon unto Christ are 14 generations. Jesus is 14. Well, what does that mean? Babylon unto Christ is 14 generations. And if you know about the zodiac sign and occult, the occult studies a 13-sign zodiac. Unlike the newspaper, if you open it up and you read your zodiac sign, it's based on 12 symbols, but the occult uses 13. And what there was before Jesus came to earth, before he was the king, there were 13 generations here before him, and those 13 generations are the Olympians, and they were terrible. They waited for Christ to come in the 14th generation that he was coming. And I'll take you on to this. This is Isaiah 14:12. And this is interchange. You look in the Good News Translation, it says, "The King of Babylon, bright morning star, you have fallen from heaven. In the past, you conquered nations, but now you have been thrown to the ground." And notice what the same scripture, this is the King James Version now. "Oh, how thou have fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning. How art thou cut down to the ground, which did weaken the nations." So what you see is King of Babylon gets interchanged with Lucifer. So Lucifer is the King of Babylon, and the King of Babylon is the first 13 generations that were here on earth. Now the Council of Nine were set up to punish mankind.
Well, on this, what is Lucifer? Lucifer is the Council of Nine joining together. And I'm just going to take you around what we see right here, right now. Okay, you have the Statler building, which is in the shape of the three. You have the new courthouse building, which is in the shape of a one, which represents 13. So from the sky, you'll see a one and a three. That's 13. You also have this obelisk that's in the middle of it all. And within this is a sacrifice symbol that you have that's laid out. Council of Nine, as you go down there, it shows the 12 Olympians, and they'll have Hermes. And then on the old courthouse building, you see the face of Hermes. And down at the end, you have the soldiers and sailors obelisk that you can see. And that soldiers and sailors obelisk has an interesting date on it. It's 5882 BC. Now going to this building here, this is Buffalo City Hall that's featured in Snoop Dogg's video, California Roll. Over there on the side, you have the goddess Demeter. Demeter is known as Callisto, and she was the one that was raped that gave birth to a child. That child was to be killed by Hera. That's Hera right there with the whisper, putting a finger over her mouth, whispering to you. Next to her is Zeus. It's up on the top. Those symbols on the top, when you see a star inside of a circle, you know it as a pentagram. But it has another light star that's within it, if you notice. And what that represents, the 10-sided star represents the Freemasons. That pentagram represents Satan, as said by Aleister Crowley. The 10-sided star represents the Masons. What are they? They are Satan's people. As we and to know who Lucifer is, there's a gateway god to Lucifer. The gateway god to Lucifer is called Hermes. Hermes is Apollo by day, then Hermes by night. As you look and you see the architecture here, go right around the corner, because the full Council of Nine is represented on this building. Vinage, notice that. Okay, if you read Revelations, the ones that are unsuccessful become plants in the future in hell. They get implanted into the ground. And what it says is that they'll harvest them, mock them and harvest them. Here you got Grover Cleveland. He's on an obelisk. This is a Greek-style obelisk. That obelisk back there is an Egyptian-style obelisk. Going around the corner here, and you will see Apollo. Apollo is on the left-hand side up here. Is Athena, the goddess of war, and she's raining down something from that, but that's Apollo. You can tell by his hairstyle. Okay, agriculture again. Go around the building. It's about the building of the harvest, the children of the damned, the children of Israel. That's who it's all about. Coming around to this side, and what we're going to see next is the full Council of Nine again around this building. If I can get there, okay. All right, we look up right there. You see, there's Aphrodite. Aphrodite has her breast out. You can see her boobs poking out. This side, as we go through, we will see Hermes. How can you tell Hermes? You can tell Hermes by the wings on the side of his helmet. Or on the side of his head, whatever it may be, he's playing the pan flute. He is the brother of Satan. And he is the gateway god. He is the one. No one gets fame, fortune, or notoriety without the assistance of Hermes. Hermes is known as Agni in the Vedas. And coming around this corner, we're going to finish up at a Council of Nine. And the Council of Nine, what they're all about is to punish humanity, to punish mankind, to take them to the pit of hell and to torture them for all of eternity. And these are on the buildings on these inner cities. They're all over. It's like this throughout every place in the world. Now, they look different. You go to India, you'll see different things, but it all represents the same gods. You just need to know what you're seeing. Fruitage, vinage.
These are the last two of the nine images that you see on the Buffalo City Hall building. To the left, you have Hepataeus. Hepataeus is in the form of Ares. If he was in the form of Hepataeus, he would have a big beard, but he is in the form of Ares, the god of war. Notice that he's holding the staff. Next to him to the right is not a council member, but one of the 12 Olympians, and that's Hestia. You could tell that by she's dropping down leaves. She's giving to the children of Israel, and that is Hestia. This is Buffalo City Hall building, and what it's showing you is that you have Council of Nine members there to punish mankind. Inside the building, it has very strange architecture that you'll see. It looks like mostly Native American stuff that's inside. As you go on the rest of the outside of the building, going up to the top, you have two serpents rising at the top of the building. You also have pyramids on the building, eyes on the building, and you have images of something coming down, as well as when you see Buffalo City Hall at night, it shines a blue light into the sky at night, and I see it from my house. It's definitely a substantial light. Also, this building, I'm going to go through this, you know, the surroundings and these videos coming up, and show you, Lucifer. Lucifer's everywhere around this building. Also, too, we're going to show that it's an apocalypse building. What this represents is the end of days. And Buffalo City Hall, you know, I could see a courthouse being there to punish mankind, but it's the City Hall building. And that's what you see. That's the significance of it. That's why it's in the Snoop Dogg video, because it represents Lucifer, as does he. Okay, this is a recap of what we've seen at Buffalo City Hall. So going around the outside of the building, that's exactly what Buffalo City Hall is, who controls it, and what is going on. They're not just putting those images up there. It's this Buffalo is not the only city like this. I mean, this is a very significant building, but this is like this everywhere. Every city of the world has the same symbolism, same type of symbolism, but it's just a little bit different depending on the culture that was presented there and how God is served and how they're projected. Now, what it is, this is Lucifer, and this is the gods of Lucifer, and the people that follow the religion, the Luciferianism, the people that are members of the Golden Dawn, the OTO sex occult. That's what they follow. This is their religion. And these are the people that are in charge of this world, folks, just to make you aware. Now, what I'm going to show you, again, this is a religious building. And this is the front mural right here. And you see, and this image here goes back to the advice in the Bible of Jethro, the father-in-law of Moses. Jethro tells Moses, gives him advice on how to control the children of Israel and get leadership over them. And you see that the gods in this image control the tradesmen, and then the tradesmen control the average workers. And you see that the gods are sitting on the side. If you can notice to the right, there is a god that's leaning. He has his elbow up and he's resting it on his head. Well, what he's resting his elbow on is there's an owl inside of a box. And that owl sits on top of the globe. Now, the owl is the same owl that you'll find on your dollar bill. It's the same owl that you'll find at the Bohemian Club, the Bohemian Grove. And that owl is Moloch. That's also the same owl that you see around Washington, D.C. And that comes from the story of Lamia. Now, Lamia is in Greek, but Lamia is Isis in Egyptian mythology. And the story of Lamia is that she lost her family, and out of despair, she surrendered and became this child-eating demon. And that's exactly what happened to Isis. And in my other videos, if you look, you see that, you know, it's always about that owl. It's about that woman that's projected in the stars are right card in the Illuminati card game. And that's exactly what you're seeing. These are the gods of the Luciferians, the members, the Order of the Golden Dawn. Okay, the OTO sex occult. That's who these people are. All right, as we go through the images, I'm just going to breeze through them real quickly. Here's Hera again. She's saying, shh, quiet. Okay, that's, you know, and that's exactly what it is. You don't know about this going on. Few people know about this going on. Okay, earlier in my life, I was oblivious, clueless to all this going on. All right, and here is Hera, a little bit about Wikipedia of her. And all these Council of Nine members are in the Bible. The Bible is basically about them. The Old Testament, once it goes into Kings, it's all about them. It's all about the Council of Nine members. And they have these different names. But if you research, you'll find the connections. You'll find, like, Aphrodite, she comes in with different names in the Bible. Where Hera here is represented as the Queen of Heaven. The Queen of Heaven in Jeremiah 7:18 of the King James Version. And here's a look at both Christianity and this is Hinduism. And it's called polytheism. They're both the same thing. You notice in the bottom picture, you have all types of gods in the Hindu religion. Well, you look at top, and you have all types of saints in Christianity. And the saints in the Bible are the gods in the Vedas. And anyone that reads those two books sees how those two interconnect. Okay, and what it is, it's polytheism. Okay, to pray to St. Thomas, the saints are the gods, or they're the lesser than. They're the man gods, as Aleister Crowley describes them. And you see, like, Apollos in the Bible, that's a reflection of a man god. But what you see here is polytheism. It's putting another before God. The mere fact of the name Christianity is a violation of the first commandment, because you'll have no gods before me. And you're calling, oh, I'm a Christian. Okay, well, God the Father's name is Adonai. Okay, so what does Christian have to do? You know, yes, Jesus is the Christ of God the Father. You serve God the Father through his Christ Jesus. Yes, that is correct. But you do not call yourself a Christian. No, you're a servant of the Master. Okay, and Zeus, next to Hera. Well, Zeus in the Bible, I'll show you what goes on and where Christianity came from all this. But here first, you have Acts 14:12 of the King James Version of the Bible. Notice Barnabas, Jupiter, and Paul, Mercurius. Okay, well, take that to Acts 14:12 of the Contemporary English Version. And you notice that Barnabas, Jupiter, Barnabas, the name Zeus. The people then gave Barnabas the name Zeus. Okay, so that's telling you that Barnabas is Zeus right there. But also, too, when you reflect back to the King James Version, it's telling you where you see Jupiter in the Bible. That means that you're seeing Zeus. That's how the names reflect, and that's how the different names that you see appear in the Bible. And that's who they are. And you'll trace it back. You'll see Jupiter, know that it's Zeus. And also, look here, Paul, the name Hermes in Acts 14:12 of the Contemporary. So Paul is Hermes. And Hermes is the council of nine members. Zeus is the council of nine member. Okay, you go down, take it, Paul, Mercury. So Barnabas is Jupiter and is Zeus, and Paul is Mercury and is Hermes. And openly known, Mercury is Hermes, as far as the people that study the stars. Okay, on to this next one here, because this is going to be the telling part here. This is Acts 11:26 of the King James Version. And this is where Christianity started. And we'll go through this and explain this to you. Okay, for a whole year they assembled themselves with the church and taught much people. All the disciples were called Christians first in Antioch. Okay, first I'm going to tell you who Antioch is. Antioch is two beasts joined together, but it's also a city. Just like Athena, Athens. Well, Antioch represents Anubis. Anubis, another name is Annie that he goes by. And Toth has to do with Toth. And if in the Egyptian Book of the Dead, Toth is another name for Horus. Okay, so you have basically Satan and Horus joined together, but it's a reflection, an ego of Horus, which is Toth. Okay, so Antioch. All right, on to the next. This is Acts 11:26. Now, it's the same scripture, but it's a different Bible. It's God's words translation. All right, and see, Barnabas and Saul met with the church in Antioch for a whole year and taught a large group of people. The disciples were called Christians for the first time in the city of Antioch. Okay, so it's saying Barnabas, Zeus, was the one that was teaching Christianity, the beginning of Christianity. Zeus was. And who's Saul? Well, if you know about Saul, the Apostle Paul, commonly known as Saint Paul, also known by his native name, Saul of Tarsus. So Paul, the apostle, is Saul. So Barnabas and Zeus are the ones that taught Christianity. They are the creators of Christianity. Christianity is not a religion taught by Jesus. Okay, because Christianity is a complete violation of the law of God. You see, especially two Kings 17, it goes through and it reflects a lot of the violations, the sitting, the standing, the kneeling, the other things, the singing. You don't sing while you give praise to God. Okay, so Zeus and Hermes started Christianity. Here is a picture of Hermes next to Aphrodite. And Hermes plays the pan flute. Hermes plays the pan flute to call the god Pan. Pan is the god of nature. You also know Pan as Satan. And there is a scripture in the Bible where Jesus speaks to Peter and he says, "Get behind me, Satan." And he says that to him. Why? Because Peter is the Pan. He is an ego of a reflection, as I explained through, you know, the other videos. So Peter is the Pan. He's not mocking him. Like, "You're Satan." No, he's like, "Get behind me, Satan." Because he is the Pan. That's not a derogatory term that's just made up and, you know, "I'm going to call you something. I'm calling you a name." No, he's calling him who he is. Okay, so he plays that pan flute to summons him. Now, there is when both Hermes and Anubis are together. They create a god that you see. Here's the statue of him in the Vatican. It's called Hermanibus. Hermanibus is the two. He's Hermes and Anubis combined together. Now, we'll take a look at the statue of Hermanibus, and I'm telling you what you're seeing. First, you have the dog. The dog head is Anubis. Excuse me. And you see, it's carrying that staff. That staff is the staff that Hermes carries. He has that staff with the wing on it and a serpent climbing up it. Also notice in the middle of his head between the two ears, he has that disc. That disc means something. When you see that in ancient Egyptian mythology and they have that disc over their head, sometimes the images will. That means under the control of, and it's a black disc. And it's under control of the black sun, under God's control, under the control of Adonai. That's what it means. Also, two, look at Anubis, see his right hand. And what he's holding there is a man's penis. Tore his penis off. Also, after you look, you see Hermes again. This is the medical symbol with Hermes. Hermes staff on it. And that's who it is. He's also the god of transit. When you go outside of, if you're in New York City and their bus station, or not the bus station, the train station, outside the train station, they have a gigantic image of Hermes. He's the god of commerce. And he's also the god of our medicine. And he's the god of liars, gamblers, and thieves. That's who he is. No one gets fame, fortune, or notoriety, again, as I mentioned previously, without the assistance of Hermes. This is said in the Vedas about Agni, but Agni is Hermes. And Hermes is the one that you see, his stuff is on everything with the medical system. And if you know about medications, if you do your research, do your homework on medications that you take, you'll find that all medications prescribed by doctors go back to poisonous plants. Oh, poison to kick the bacteria out of us? No, no, our bodies are oxygen-based. So all of our medicines should be oxygen-based medicines, but they're not. They're bacteria. Why? To cause side effects. What types of side effects? Our death. That's the reason. All right, next to Hermes, you have Aphrodite. Aphrodite again, here's an image of her. You know, she's got, always has the breast out. She's got the best statues. Just joking, but yeah. All right, next here we go on to Apollo and Athena. Okay, Apollo, he is in the Bible. Here is 1 Maccabees 3:12, and this is the New Revised Standard Version. This is the Apocrypha Bible. If you have a standard Bible, this scripture will not be in there. What does, when you see a King James Version, the King James Version is called the Authorized Version. The reason why it's called the Authorized Version, meaning you're allowed to see that version. The other version became the Apocrypha, which means in ancient Greek, the hidden version. So this is part of the hidden version of the Bible, a part that King James didn't want our generations to see. And you see, Judas took the sword of Apollyonus. Well, it's Apollo. Judas took the sword of Apollo and used it in battle the rest of his life. Well, what did Judas do? Now, this isn't the Judas that walked with Jesus. This Judas here is Judas of Maccabees. And Judas, the word, is it's a name, but it's also has a meaning, a definition to it. Judas is an original inhabitant of the land. That's a Judas, a Judean. That's what it stands for. And that's where the term or the abbreviation comes from of Jew. It's for Judean, original inhabitant. Okay, so Judas takes the sword of Apollo, and what does he do with it? If you read the book, he steals the knowledge from our past generations, our descendants. What he does is he takes that sword. Oh, you got that book? You surrender that book, or I'll kill your whole family. And he would kill their whole family. And others would surrender the book. But ultimately, through the generations, they lose the knowledge because they surrendered the books of God. He came and stole the knowledge from them when he got the sword of Apollo. That's what that is about. And here is a picture of Apollo. And then look at him. That's him. That's him. That's Apollo. Okay, next we go on. You see there's Athena. And Athena is raining down, looks like nails or something along those lines. Well, what it is Athena is the goddess of war. And what her job to do, Athens, as I said, was named after Athena, a state of war. That's what she is. That's why she is there, to punish us. Okay, on to this next. What we see here is Demeter. Demeter, as I said, she has many names. She goes back to Isis, Lamia, Castilio. And what she was is she's also Hathor. Hathor, the whore, an ancient Egyptian. Well, what happened to her is, I'm going to explain the whole story, but she was raped and she gave birth to a child. There's that child. Whenever you go past a church and you see a mother holding a baby, that's a Mother Mary. Well, Mary is another thing. She is a Mary, but I didn't mention her name is Mary. Why is that? Well, Mary is just like I mentioned previously, a term, a Miriam. Well, what does Miriam mean? Miriam means gift child from God. That's what the term Mary means. So when you see the Mother Mary, that means that she received a gift child from God. And that gift child that was held up is in ancient Egyptian mythology, Anubis, or Satan. So when you go past the church and you see a mother holding a baby, what you see is Isis holding Satan. That's what you see. And who is that child? That child is described very well in Ephesians 2:2, King James Version of the Bible. The prince of power of the air, the spirit, that now worketh in the children of disobedience. Okay, you're disobedient to God? Okay, then he's going to work his way into you. What do I read there? What does that mean? The power of air and spirit. Well, that's the pentagram. If you know what the pentagram, earth, wind, fire, when you see hear these terms or these names, what it's talking about, it goes back to that pentagram. It's all about the pentagram. And you see, you know, Russia uses the pentagram, United States uses the pentagram, North Korea uses it on their military. And you look for on military uniforms and you will see that pentagram. You'll go through them all throughout the world, and I bet you find them all on some capacity. You definitely will find it there, because the wars are his toys, the prince of this realm, the prince of this earth. That's who it is. That's who that child is. And that's who Satan is. Okay, and this is the last image that we have up on there. And this completes the nine members that you see. And to the left, you have Aries. Well, he's not a Council of Nine member, but Hepataeus is. And Aries is a young version, a young, handsome version. And Hepataeus is the brother in mythology, it says. And he's the old, ugly version. Well, Ares is the god of war. And Hepataeus is the weapon maker for war. And they're the same being, but they're split, an ego of one another. And what he's there for is, again, to punish mankind, just like Athena, goddess of war, and then you have Ares, a god of war. They're here to punish us, and that's what it represents. And then the very last one, you have Hestia. Now, Hestia does good for mankind, just like Dionysus, Prometheus, Jesus. Gives the blessings to mankind. So that's what you get. You go to City Hall, you get some good things, but it's not there just for the good things. You're going to get good, but you're also going to get punished too. One thing that really amazed me when I was reading Aleister Crowley's book, I read the book in Magic in Theory and Practice. And in his book, he says, he was talking about on how they get enlightenment and what they do. And ultimately they use the Trinity. The Trinity is black magic. And you hear the Trinity at the church, but if you knew what they're talking about, they're talking about black magic. And it'll have an evil God and then an evil God and then a good God. And Christ was in it, in this one magical thing that he had presented. And it was just, it blew my mind. It was like something that I wanted to reject immediately. But what is it? They get the euphoric. They get the great feeling, the joy from it all. And that's who Jesus is. But in that black magic practice, if you obey God's law, the dark side, Adonai, Genesis 1:4, have to bring it up again. God split the light from the darkness and the light was good. Well, God the Father stayed the darkness. And he is Adonai. And if you read in the book of Enoch, what it says is after God split the light from the darkness tortured the light. Very important to know who God the Father is and what God the Father is. Now, God the Father is past, present, and future. And God himself is past, present, and future. However, in our current reality, God the Father has split the light from the darkness. And in our future, there will be the marriage in Revelation where God the Father marries the bridegroom. The bridegroom, as I explained a bunch of times, is Jesus. Jesus, again, will unite. The light and the darkness will form as one again. You must obey the law of God because everyone will be judged properly. And you'll get exactly what you earn. So do whatever you can. Warn whoever you can. Warn the ones you love. Warn everybody. This knowledge that you have is worth more than the largest bank account ever. And you can multiply it by infinity. And it still is larger than that. Okay, the last one, Council of Nine member, that doesn't appear on there, but I'm sure he's in that building somewhere, is Poisedon. That's the only one that wasn't there. He was replaced with Hestia. And Poisedon, if you read in some versions of the Bible, you know, Poisedon comes up from the sea, the Kraken, and that's in the Bible, folks. That creature, that beast really does exist. So, all right, with the rest of this video is going to take you through the city of Buffalo, and it's going to be, you know, just walking through the city and seeing the images of Lucifer. But on top of that, also, too, it's going to teach you about the universe, how it started, and how we got to here today. In this video, I will demonstrate that our medical system is Lucifer. Our all organized religions are Lucifer. The legal system is Lucifer. Lucifer is the Council of Nine. I will start with the medical system, the Catechism of Hermes and the Rod of Asclepius. You notice on ambulances from around the world, you see the same symbolism. What does that tell you? It should tell you that the medical system is larger than any country or any entity from outside the country. Just like a Mason Lodge is in every community of the world, it should tell you that the Masons are larger than any system of government, democratic, socialist, communist, or dictatorship. You never hear of a dictator telling Freemasons to leave. Or just like an obelisk being erected in every city of the world, past and present, all these different cultures just happen to adopt and agree on the same object that defies reason. And obviously, it defies logic. There is something greater than our world's governments. Well, the mythology of the Catechism of Hermes is two snakes that were fighting in the desert, and the snakes came in agreement after Hermes threw down his staff, and the two snakes joined together as one. The two snakes that were fighting in the desert were Set, or Seth, and Horus. This was in Upper and Lower Egypt, Egyptian mythology tells us. Set is a snake, and Horus is a snake bird. Horus is a bird that was born from snake parents. Now, the Egyptian gods Geb and Nut, Amun-Ra creates this universe, and he has two children, Geb and Nut. Geb being the earth, and Nut being nature. The Yabaloth, also known as Abba, is Amun-Ra. Amun-Ra has another name. If you look on Wikipedia, he goes by Amen. When you see Amen in the Bible, it means a couple things. It means to, first, it means to the God, Amun-Ra. And Amen, just like when you hear amendment to the Constitution, it means to alter your outcome. Jim Morrison says, protest God through prayer. And that is exactly right. Amun-Ra, again, gave birth to two children, Geb, which is the earth, and Nut, which is nature. Geb is known as the father of snakes, as he produced five children. His children, male, Set, and his two sister wives, Nephilis and Heros, are also known as Taurat. And then he also had Osiris and his sister wife, Isis. So Set had two wives, and Osiris had one. Set was very jealous over Osiris's wife, Isis. Now, if you Google search Geb's children, it says that there were four. However, there were five. It's skipping Set's concubine wife at Taurat, and she's known as the Hippo. But there's five children that were born, although Wikipedia and Google, for the most part, will tell you four, but if you do your research, you'll see that there's five. Okay, Egyptian mythology says that the gods would have a monthly banquet here on Earth. Seth came to the banquet and offered a beautiful crafted box set. Seth said, whichever one of you fits inside the box can have it. He gave a chance to his brother Osiris first to win. Osiris, once he was in the box, Seth slammed it closed. He pushed Osiris into the Nile River where he drowned. The box was the very first coffin. There was no feud at that point. Seth killed Osiris for no reason, just the jealousy of Isis. And Osiris, his sister wife, Seth desired to have Isis. Seth is a jealous god. Seth would turn himself into a bull when in the presence of Isis to attract her. And where you see the bull, that's a representation of Seth. Now Seth then took Osiris's body after it was in the coffin and drowned. He chopped up, dismembered him, chopped up his body parts, and he scattered his body parts across the Egyptian desert. Osiris's sister wife, Isis, went through the desert and gathered his body parts and brought him back to life long enough to conceive a son named Horus. Isis very much did love Osiris. Osiris then entered the afterlife and became the ruler of the dead. Horus was born. He was born again, that snake eagle, and he went on to avenge his father's death and battle Seth. Horus began battling Seth, and they had epic battles between, again, Upper and Lower Egypt. And one of the battles, Horus was about to kill Seth, and Isis came up and stopped him. Seth recovered and then tried to rape Horus after that. Excuse me. And during that process, Horus managed to cut off Seth's testicles. But in that fight also, too, Horus ended up losing an eye. Seth then took the eye and impregnated Isis with it. It's the story of Zeus raping Callisto in Greek mythology. Well, Isis gave birth to her child. The child was Anubis, the dog god. That's the one that you see in the video with Snoop Dogg. And Anubis, another name, is Arcus, Arcturus, Artemis, and he is Satan. Well, Isis, after the event, after she was raped, her name was changed. And her name was changed to Hathor. She's called Hathor the Whore after the event. And she got a surname. And if you know about in the occult, once they get to a certain level, their names change. And that's what happened to her. And if you read the Bible, after they sacrifice, their names change. Well, Nephilis, one of Seth's sister wives, was enraged with the birth of the child. Nephilis created an army to destroy the child called the Nephilim. And what the Nephilim are is winged locusts. Anubis countered with his army, the Anunnaki, the ant people. What happened was Arcus went to Zeus in mythology, and Zeus created him an army of ant warriors to fight. Well, going on from there, so the Anunnaki fought great wars against the Nephilis. Nephilis from Nephilim, Anunnaki from Anubis. At some point, Seth absorbed Geb. Seth absorbed Amun-Ra. He killed his father and took his power, the Greek story of Zeus killing and absorbing his father, Cronus. Seth rose to be the king of kings, the conqueror of all. And he goes by many names, Seth, Zeus, or Adonai in the Bible. In the beginning, God split the light from the darkness. And this is reflected inside the Gospel of Judas, where Judas says The God is Seth and Jesus. And that's exactly what it is. Jesus is the Christ of God, the good, the light, the mercy. And Adonai is the Father, the fierceness, the terror of God. He is the King of Kings. How did this all begin? And what does the symbol mean of the Catechism of Hermes? So in the beginning, there was a realm called Pleroma. And this is found in Mayan mythology that you can read about Pleroma, and there's in other mythologies as well. Well, what in Pleroma, there was never no beginning. The gods weren't born. They were always there. And there will never be any end of Pleroma, pure existence, the realm of the gods. Well, the goddess Sophia from Pleroma gave birth to a child without a male consort, and it's against the rules of Pleroma. And the child was born in secrecy. The child was the Yobath, and that is Amun-Ra. Well, she hid the child and kept him as a servant, an artisan, it's called. And the child just did the work, but basically, like, keeping it in the cupboard, didn't come out to the other gods until the child got a chance to steal Sophia's power. And he created an imitation universe. If you ever hear that we're in a parallel universe, we are. We're in a parallel universe to Pleroma. This is the one with no substance. Theirs is the one with great substance. Well, in that realm, another god was looking on. It was a jaguar god. This is the beginning of it all. And the jaguar god had a fascination with the darkness, or better said, a being within the darkness. The jaguar went inside the darkness and became lost, and was lost for a very long time. A winged serpent, the winged serpent was Hermes, or Lucifer, approached the jaguar inside the darkness and offered help. Jaguar saw the winged serpent as not being a threat. So the jaguar naively took advice and listened to the winged serpent, went into the light as the winged serpent directed him to, and was trapped and is trapped for all of eternity. That god became the children of Israel today, shredded into mankind. So again, the origin of the Catechism of Hermes, what happened was Hermes is a reflection of Horus, and this can be found in the Egyptian Book of the Dead. It says that Horus is Thoth. Aleister Crowley in the Book of Thoth says that Thoth is Hermes. So, and if you know about my other videos about the egos, Hermes is a creation of Horus. And when Horus went there and Hermes threw down its staff and Seth and Horus went up it, Horus surrendered to Seth and he became Aquila. Aquila is the eagle of Zeus, and that's something that you'll find in the Bible. And he became a servant, just like Isis surrendered to after great grief, and she became the child-eating demon, the owl. Well, the Catechism of Hermes symbol is the pharmaceutical logo. And you see it on ambulances, you see it in hospitals. And why is that from that event? And I'm going to tell you what it means. The mythology, Greek, of the symbol of two snakes that were fighting in the desert, threw down a staff in agreement. The two snakes are found in Egyptian mythology, Horus and Seth, in Upper and Lower Egypt. Now, as it goes into what the definition of it all is it means to help the merchant, liars, and thieves. Merchants, liars, and thieves. That's what that symbol goes to. And here is a scripture from the Bible. This is King James Version of the Bible. It's 2 Timothy 4:19. Salute Priscilla, Aquila, and the household of one Sepphoris. This is the joining. This is what it means, the Catechus of Hermes symbol. This scripture right here. One Seth and Horus. Who is it? Priscilla and Aquila. Aquila is the eagle of Zeus. Okay, so this is telling you Egyptian mythology right in there. Most people don't understand, and the reason why they don't understand is because they don't take the time to learn. All that seek shall find. All that seek shall find. Okay, so one Seth Horus, Seth and Horus join as one. And again, the Nephilim and the Anaki that were fighting, well, they join as one too. And Nephilis and Anubis join as one in to fight the trespasser that comes in. And that is the children of Israel today. Now you have what is called the Council of Nine. The Council of Nine was the joining of the gods by Zeus to combat against mankind. I'm going to show you in the video that the city of Buffalo, the city hall building, has the Council of Nine on it. Now you could say, well, the Council of Nine to punish mankind. Well, that'd be a courthouse. I can possibly understand it there. However, I still would not, because it's the same symbolism throughout the whole world. It's the city hall building. Why would the Council of Nine be out there if they're there to punish mankind? Well, that's exactly what they're doing. They are punishing mankind. This symbolism is shown to you people throughout the world. And, you know, if you already know about it, don't take offense. But if you don't know what I'm talking about, take offense. Definitely take offense, because you need to learn about this, okay? You need to focus on what's important and what's not important. Knowing about God is your wealth in the afterlife. It's also your wealth in this life. I mean, protection. You know, you want to drive a Mercedes, you follow the ways of the devil. You want to make it to heaven, you want to be in safety, you want protection in this life, follow the ways of God. You serve God through His mercy, through His Christ Jesus, and you'll get protection. We are lied to by religions, as all religions are Lucifer. We are lied to by the medical system. If you go to a doctor's office, you see the Catechus of Hermes symbols. If you go to a dentist's office, you see the Catechus of Hermes symbols. Aleister Crowley says that all of these people are his people. They are the Druids. And that's the truth. That's why they go under these symbols. They have to. It's a requirement of the Covenant of the Morning Stars. If you don't know what the Covenant of the Morning Stars is, it's Job 38:7. It's an agreement between Lucifer and Jesus. And I go through this in a bunch of videos. And that's what it is. If you ever read about the Kabbalah, our eyes are not allowed to see the Kabbalah. But if you read books about the Kabbalah, what they call the children of Israel is the children of the covenant. And what that covenant is the covenant of the morning stars, reflected in Job 38:7. So when you see that symbolism, Catechus of Hermes symbol, and you also see the number six represents the planet Saturn. Saturn in the occult is Satan. And you see these two things on ambulances throughout the world. It's the same exact symbolism that goes through the whole world. You would think that maybe, oh, we want something different here. Someone would think a little bit differently. No, they don't, because it's a controlled thing. It's a controlled entity that's above us. So the whole system is controlled. The whole medical system throughout the world is under control. It's under Zion control. If you know that Donald Trump is the high priest of Zion, he is was and has been for a long time. And people that follow politics, you know, have a very hard time with, you know, the Biden's against Trump. And yeah, Biden works for Trump. Biden is Trump's guy. They're Nazis, like I show in the videos. But back to the subject of matter here. Okay, so the symbolism that we see in the hospitals all go back to Lucifer, and I've covered that in other videos, the video Lucifer that I made. Also, too, the symbolism that we see in the churches all goes back to Lucifer. If you look at Hinduism, and then you look at Christianity, and you see the same type of symbolism. Although in Hinduism they call them gods, in Christianity they call them saints, but they're the same thing. If you were to read the Vedas and read the Bible, you'll see that they're reflecting on the same ideas, like the obelisk called pillars, sacrifice pillars. Okay, they're called obelisk in some versions of the Bible, not the King James, but in some versions. And those two things are both Lucifer. The symbolism all matches up, and if you read the books, it matches up. But if you hear about the two religions, you know, they're at the polar opposites. However, they're not. It's the same thing, folks. The true religion is Islam. But again, if you've seen my other videos, Islamic instruction is pure deception. So to call yourself a Muslim is a great thing, and it will benefit you greatly. However, like the Quran repeats, because the Quran repeats itself for clear communication, you do have to read the Quran and believe the words of the Quran, because the Quran tells you that the Bible, the Old Testament and the New Testament, are the truth. But if you talk to an Islamic instructor, they're going to tell you, oh, they're telling you wrong things, that, oh, the Bible was tampered with. And no man or God could tamper with God's book. So know that it's the truth. And this is going through the city. This is where you see Lucifer. Who is Lucifer? Who is Hermes? Hermes is very important in the Council of Nine. Hermes joining with Zeus together is Nimrod. And they are against mankind. Although Zeus is the high order, he is the father. Like I said, he is Adonai, he is Seth. And again, I'm going to reflect on when the darkness was split from the light and Jesus was the light, the father is the rage. Okay, and in our present time, God is split the light from the darkness. In our future, in the marriage in Revelation, the light and the darkness will join together. Jesus is called the bridegroom at that time, where they'll reunite again. In our present, we have to honor the Father, and we honor the Father through the blood of Jesus Christ. And something I want to mention, if someone died being a polytheist, that's following the religion of Christianity, multiple gods, they don't see it, but it is. But if someone that you know died a polytheist, you can pray for them and their sins will be forgiven, depending on your actions. However, if they're among the living, it's a sin for you to pray for them for following those sins, so you need to inform them. Okay, in this video, I'm showing you that Hermes, he is the god of sacrifice. He's the gateway god to the Council of Nine, which is Lucifer. And Hermes is on all these different buildings throughout the city of Buffalo. But it's not only the city of Buffalo, although it is featured in the Snoop Dogg video. I've seen it in every city that I've been in. Okay, just like the obelisk, and then you got Hermes, and you got Hermes in different forms. You'll have Hermes, one in Hinduism is Agni, and you'll notice on their helmets that they have the wings are serpent wings. So that, you know, that's there. You see the two things, that Horus is the winged serpent. All right, he's a bird, and he's also a serpent. And the Council of Nine is out to punish mankind. And that's what it's all about. We are at war, folks, and this is who the enemy is. But if you don't look, you're not going to learn. If you don't look, you're not going to be safe. You must pray to the Father in Jesus' name. Jesus was our blood sacrifice. Jesus died as a lamb for our sins to be forgiven. And he died as a virgin for our prayers to be answered. And it's all in the form of black magic. It truly is. If you read Leviticus, the third book of the Bible, you'll understand what I'm saying. You'll see what I'm saying is true. The people that fight with me, the Muslims that fight with me and have disagreements, are the ones that never read the Quran. The Christians don't open up and read the Bible. They're told what to think. They don't read it. And if they do read it, they get a little bit confused and they stop. You got to seek the truth. You got to seek with all your heart to escape. Times are getting tough. The reason for the vaccinations, folks, is very simple. What they're doing is putting chips inside people. That's why there's no chips for cars. There's no chips for anything. They're microchipping people for the gathering, because the marriage is coming soon. So honor the Father. Pray to the Father and repent in Jesus' name. His death was for our success. The pyramids, if you didn't watch my other videos, what the pyramids are, they're covenant stones. Covenant of the morning stars. That's what they're there for. It was for the death. Jesus didn't die by chance. Jesus' death was a predetermined thing. Okay, God the Father gets all the praise, all the glory for giving, allowing his Christ to come. Because that is him. That is who he is. So all praise, honor, and glory to the Father. Amen. That my driver's license is a negotiable instrument. I do not wish to enter into any contracts with you. Therefore, I do not speak to strangers. They ask you again, be very blunt. I do not speak to strangers. If they ask again and the law enforcement officer demands your license, you give them the license and say, I give this to you, my license, under duress. I do not wish to enter into any contracts with you. And of course, refuse to sign anything. If they force you to sign, be sure to put a V period, C period before you sign your name, and put the V period, C period above your name too. This goes back to an ancient Roman meaning under duress. And like the magistrate courts, where you go to a court for your sentencing or your punishment, a magistrate has the same name as it did back in ancient Rome. Because most people don't know this, however, we are still under that same Roman rule today. And you could see it with your eyes when you enter into a courthouse. You walk in, you see outside or inside or both, you see the Roman gods. If you know my videos, or if you know Romans 16, the Roman gods are Lucifer. You're entering into the house of Lucifer. And, you know, so these ancient terms are still in effect today because it's ancient Rome that you're dealing with. And when you get those contracts from Lucifer, you got to know where your contracts are coming from and how to handle them. And while I'm on this topic, if you ever do get arrested, and the police officer is reading your rights and ask you, do you understand these rights? You say no. Why? Well, they probably will get mad, but you say no because by saying yes, you are admitting guilt. The legal system has a different language that is meant to trick us. The language is called legalese. the language of the courts. There is a dictionary that offers the terms of legalese that's called the Black's Law Dictionary. I own a copy. However, I looked at it twice, maybe. But if you need a definition looked up, I could help you. But anything further than that, I know little to nothing about. The whole legal system, again, is Lucifer offering you contracts. The police are here to serve and protect the people. And however, you know, you consider yourself a person, as I do, but however, if you have a birth certificate, you are a citizen, not a people of the United States. Very important that you know that. We are citizens, not the people. And again, never say yes to understanding your rights. Again, it is legalese, and you are admitting guilt. It's not like, oh, do you understand this? No, you're saying, yes, I am guilty to committing this crime, officer. That's what you're saying. Be aware of that. And also, never ever allow them to fingerprint you. Never allow them to take a picture of you. And try not to sign anything. But if you feel forced to sign, then sign only with a V period C period above and before your signature.